Good morning, everyone present here. I, Priyanka Mahapatra, welcome you here for a special assembly of solid waste management. First of all, I want to tell you about waste management. Waste management are the activity and action required to manage. Waste can be solid, liquid, and gaseous. Each type has different method of disposal. Awareness of waste in India. About 429 million of citizens are there. Out of 5.6 million tons of plastic garbage is produced. More than 70% of garbage is freely dumped into landfills. Where India stands in waste management system? The European has 445, China has 150, and USA has 86. Whereas India has only 8 of waste management system. If India starts collecting and treating its waste effectively, then it could generate a lot of energy. Thank you.
Good morning, one and all present here. I, Prasanna of Class 8, will tell you something about solid waste management in Nepal. Management of solid waste is a growing concern in Nepal. As urban population densities increase and flat usable is a short supply. With increasing population, in that country, awareness for good health and clean environment. Solid waste management has now come to the top of the priorities of a municipality in Nepal. These residents refuse to accept waste near their houses, and even though collection systems are still not in place, most of the municipalities are expressing their views and are expressing their desire to develop a final disposal system. They are also promoting waste reduction, reuse among them. Thank you.
It would be great if no household waste was actually wasted. Well, good morning to one and all present here. Today, I am going to tell you about the solid waste management in Sweden. Sweden boasts up to have the best solid waste management system in the world. More than 99% of all the household waste is separated and recycled in one way or another. Sweden has more than 50% of all the household waste is burned to produce energy. This rule was started in 1975 and it boasts up to have a zero garbage country by 2020. Thank you.
Sweden is almost there. Over 99% of household waste is recycled in one way or another. This means that the country has gone through recycling revolution in last decade. Concerning only 38% of household waste is recycled in 1975. Today, recycling station is no more than 300 meters away from residential area. In Sweden, plastic containers are converted into raw materials to form new items. Food is composted and became soil and biogas with the chemical processes. This means that the country has produced less toxic substance in production of fewer products that needed to be treatment. Can we learn from Sweden? It is the big question for us. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. Today, Samriddhi will tell you about the three different kinds of dustbin we use. Segregation of waste is very important, but it becomes difficult when we mix it all together with different kinds of waste. To make it easier, we divide dustbins into three kinds. These are the green dustbin for biodegradable waste such as vegetable peels, fruit peels, etc. The blue dustbin for non-biodegradable waste, for example, paper, wood, plastic, etc. And the black dustbin for hazardous waste such as toxic materials, hospital waste, chemicals, etc. I hope that you understand that what these three dustbins are used for and will promise to make India a cleaner country.
Good morning all of you. I am Vamsi from class 8A and I am here to tell you what is solid waste management. We produce a lot of waste in our day-to-day life, but managing it properly is called waste management. All the waste which is solid in state is solid waste. So managing all the solid waste is solid waste management. First of all, I would like to tell you that Goa City, the place almost all of us live, is a zero garbage zone. That doesn't mean that no garbage is produced here, but all garbage produced here is reused or converted into compost. Non-biodegradable waste is reused, reduced or recycled, whereas biodegradable waste is turned into compost. What as students we can take to manage waste? We should follow the 3 R's, that is reduce, reuse and recycle. I hope you all of you understand. Let's see how you can do it.
Good morning one and all present here. Today, Aishwarya Gautam of class 8 will tell you something about reuse. Do you know what reuse exactly means? Let me tell you. Reuse means to use a thing again, specially in a different way or after reclaiming or reprocessing the need of the scarce material. We can make many things by reusing our old materials like lampshades, a charger dock, etc. Step outside the box and start working with your minds. Think of new ways that you can integrate your waste material and can produce a more productive enterprise. You know your business waste better than anyone else. So start stepping outside the box and create new materials using your old materials. Thank you.
Good morning to one and all present here. Today, myself Shruti Sinha from class 8A is going to speak some few lines on the topic reduce. Reduce means to make something smaller in quantity, size, shape, etc. It is more important than ever to reduce the amount of natural resources being produced or manufactured. We should use the reducing process because it will reduce the packaging waste, energy consumption to handle the waste that is being produced. There are some methods to reduce the waste that are shop for durable goods, look for items at second-hand stores, buy the products in bulk and reduce the plastic use. Thank you.
Never refuse to reuse, reduce or recycle. What is recycle? A very fresh good morning to one and all present here. Today, I, Garima Alak Tripathi, is here to tell you something on recycling. Recycling is transformation of a material into its raw form and again using it as useful material. We can recycle paper, newspaper, glass jars, etc. Recycling is very important as waste has a very huge negative impact on our environment. Harmful chemicals and greenhouse gases are released from the landfill sites. It helps us to reduce the amount of pollution caused by waste. So, our motto should be the 3 R's, reuse, reduce, recycle. Thank you.
A very good morning to all of you present here. Now I, Kitanshi Mehra, is here to tell you about the importance of making the best out of waste. Friends, do you know what is in my hand? It is a pen stand made out of discarded plastic straws. I made something useful out of discarded waste material. The best way to reduce waste is to not create it in the first place. An effective way to reduce our waste and manage it is by reducing the waste and reusing it. It also saves our environment and also helps us save our money. Thank you and have a nice day.
Take a bag or two. No, thank you. Reduce, reuse, recycle too. Come on, everyone, it's easy to do.
When you are too big
to play with your toys, give them to other girls and boys. Reduce, reuse, recycle too. Come on, everyone, it's easy to do. When you take a rubbish to the bin, take which one you put it in. Reduce, reuse, recycle too. Come on, everyone, it's easy to do. Thank you.
Let's take a pledge on 3R. Reduce, reuse, recycle. Everyone in pledge position. I pledge
to reduce
the amount of waste
I produce.
I will
reuse
as many items
as I can.
I will recycle more
and I will buy things made up of
recycled content.
And I will encourage my
colleagues and friends
to take the 3R pledge.
Thank you.